Hi guys, thanks for stopping by the 8th episode recap of Hometown Cha-Cha-Cha. With a plot spoiler alert, let's get to the episode. Episode starts with Seon-hun asking if Hye-jin is seeing someone. Even though Du-sik tells him she's not, he lash out at him for asking such a question from him instead of Hye-jin. He leaves grumpily, which surprises everyone. As Num-suk and others hang out at Chum Jae's shop, Yun Kung and Num-suk reveals about some of their cloths being missing. But the two men doesn't seem to take it seriously. The talk then shifts to Hye-jin, Du-sik and Seon-hun. Num-suk assumes that Hye-jin dumped Du-sik for Seon-hun, and Du thinks that both the men could have done better than Hye-jin. Min-sun overhears this and interrupts her, saying not to badmouth Hye-jin, since she was always known for her beauty. But that doesn't stop Num-suk from gossiping. Meanwhile, Hye-jin gets a visit from a group of kids. Ju rewatch the TV, and I-jun and Bora to check on their hedgehog. They have named the hedgehog Soomseum, but Hye-jin is more interested to know when they will take Soomseum back. Min-sun return and fills Hye-jin up about Num-suk bad-talking her, but Hye-jin slide it away, saying it's just her personality. But she does get offended when she hears that everyone agrees both the men are too good for her. We then see Du-sik teaching Seon-hun to surf. Instead of getting into water, Du-sik first teach him on land. But even on land, Seon-hun struggles to keep his balance. Two of Seon-hun's team, Ji-won and Du-ha, watch them with a sympathetic look. Then we see them in water, and of course Seon-hun doesn't seem to have any progress in balancing himself. Ha-jung sees Yeon-guk walking past her restaurant. She calls out for him and asks about his injury. He tells her that he's fine thanks to his good bones. Yeon-guk calls out Ha-jung to talk with him. He tells her even though they're divorced, that doesn't stop her from being his friends. So he confessed to her that he has feelings for Chu-hee, and has decided to act on it. Ha-jung straight out tells him that Chu-hee is off-limits, but doesn't give him a reason. Yeon-guk complains that he married and divorced her because she wanted it that way, and why she's so against of him having a good life. Without another word, Ha-jung leaves. Seon-hun is excited after his first day of surfing, but Du-sik doesn't even want to talk about anything that starts with letter S. So Seon-hun annoys him with a list of food that starts with letter S, and invites him for a meal. Du-sik turns him down, and as you leave, Seon-hun runs into Hye-jin and Min-sun. Seon-hun invites Hye-jin and Min-sun to join him to the meal. Min-sun leaves out saying she has gained recently, forcing Hye-jin and Seon-hun to eat alone. But Du-sik also calls himself in, and join them. The two men take their seats first. Seon-hun pulls the chair next to him for Hye-jin, but she chooses to sit next to Du-sik. To add to his frustration, Hye-jin and Du-sik shares the menu card in selecting the order. Seon-hun lighten up when Hye-jin gives him some of her dumplings and says to him that she loves to watch him eat. This time Du-sik gets annoyed, and grabs one of the dumplings Hye-jin shares with Seon-hun, and stuff it into his mouth. As Hye-jin and Seon-hun share their memories, Du-sik is interested in how they first met. We flash back to the college days. Hye-jin and Seon-hun has been assigned on the same projects. When Seon-hun suggests to discuss it over dinner, Hye-jin tells him that she need to get a student to tutor. So instead she writes down her number, and tells him to fill her up on what she needs to do. When Seon-hun worries about her dinner, Hye-jin shows him a sausage snack, saying she got it covered. Seeing as Seon-hun takes out sandwiches and snacks from his backpack, and trades them for the sausage snack, and quickly leaves before Hye-jin could reject. Seon-hun pays the bill and assures Hye-jin, as her senior he should care for her. Du-sik pays him for his portion since he's not his senior. He then leaves saying to himself that Seon-hun has a weird taste in women. Num-suk stops by Ha-jung's restaurant, after hearing about Ha-jung and Chu-hee were spotted together in a restaurant. She wants to know the details, but Ha-jung chases her out. Just then Chu-hee arrives. She hands Ha-jung some anti-wrinkle products. But Ha-jung tells Chu-hee that she doesn't like to hang out with her. Ha-jung then professionally addresses her and tells to stop coming by, since other parents wouldn't like it. Hurt by it, Chu-hee leaves after apologizing, but she leaves the gift. At the clinic, Hye-jin prepares for the inlay after Num-suk's treatment. But Num-suk refused to do it, even though Hye-jin insists that she will be in a lot of pain if she doesn't get the inlay. Regardless, she refused to do it and shares a look with other patients as she leaves. Num-suk then stops by the bank, and it seems she's a VIP customer. She asks one of the employees to let her know of any high-interest saving plans. Yoo-sik sees Yeon-kung dealing with some boxes, and runs to help her out. But Seon-hun is already helping her, so Yeon-kung tells him that she'd rather get Seon-hun's help. Disappointed, Du-sik heads to Gari's. He finds she's having a snack with her friends, which Seon-hun has brought to them. Du-sik gets annoyed when they starts to praise Seon-hun. The grandmothers notice frustration, so he quickly changes the topic to Gari's bundle. Later, Hye-jin stops by Yeon-kung's supermarket wearing a neck brace to buy some stuff. She finds Du-sik by the cashier. He asks about the neck brace, and Hye-jin explains that it's for her herniated neck disc. Du-sik is taken away by the sight of Hye-jin removing the neck brace and tying her hair. Hye-jin breaks his hypnotism by asking for her card. She explains to him that the neck pain comes with the job. After she leaves, Du-sik wonders what's wrong with him. That night, Du-sik goes through his herbs as he remembers Hye-jin's neck pain. Even though he's annoyed that he can't get it out of his mind, we see him chopping down some herbs as Gumchul walks into his house. Gumchul fears that the unborn child will be worse than Bor. Du-sik defends Bor but gets angry when Gumchul reveals that Sung-hun fixed their cash register. Ha-jung sees Ju-hee drinking alone, but she doesn't join her and walk past. Ju-hee can barely walk after all the drinking. A man comes to her and leads her away. They get spot by Ha-jung, and the man runs off, leaving Ju-hee. We see him angrily getting back home, and inside there are tons of female clothing scattered around. The next morning, the entire neighborhood is shocked by the news. Ju-hee wakes up in the hospital and Ha-jung by her side. Ha-jung yells at her for being drunk to the point she can't walk, and reveals that she was almost abducted by a stranger. As they talk, Young-guk runs to the hospital and worries over Ju-hee. At the clinic, another patient refused to get the inlay. So Hye-jin asks her patient why, because she's having many patients refusing the inlay recently. We then see Nam-suk running into Ju-ri, who seems to be upset over not having enough allowance to buy her boy band's fan merchandise. So Nam-suk gives her the money she needs, and in return she makes her promise not to wander around at night. Hye-jin interrupts their happy moment and lash out at Nam-suk for introducing her patients to a dental technician to get the inlay done. Du-sik overhears Nam-suk badmouthing dentistry. Offended by it, Hye-jin demands an apology. When Nam-suk protests, Du-sik sides with Hye-jin and tells Nam-suk that she crossed the line. Nam-suk gets hurt for Du-sik siding with Hye-jin and walks away refusing to apologize. Sung-hun is lost in thought when Ji-won and Du-ha talk about work. Ji-won suggests to have a break, which Sung-hun immediately agrees and runs off. Hye-jin fills up about Nam-suk as they head back home after work. The talk then shifts to Sung-hun. Min-sun criticizes her for not picking up Sung-hun's signals, but Hye-jin disagrees, saying Sung-hun is naturally nice to everyone. She sincerely asks her to think about Sung-hun, since she and Du-sik are just friends. Min-sun brings up about their drunken night and asks Hye-jin if Du-sik a good kisser. Even though Hye-jin claims not to remember anything, Min-sun notes her blushing. Just then Sung-hun runs to them calling out for Hye-jin. Min-sun quickly leaves them saying she has some plans elsewhere. Sung-hun gives her a baton and an alarm so she can protect herself. He also lets her borrow his lucky llama key tag and walks her home. In the meantime, Du-sik waits for Yoon-chul by the police station. He offers to join him in patrolling the area, claiming as the chief of the town, it is his job to keep everyone safe. As they take their round, it starts to rain. They decide to split up so that they could cover more ground. As Du-sik inspects the area, he notes the street light on the path to Hye-jin's house being broken. He takes out a bag and as he prepares to leave it, he spots Sung-hun and Hye-jin sharing an umbrella. Even though he's saddened to see them together, he casually hands the bag to Hye-jin saying he had some extra acanthopanax and didn't want it to waste. She offers to lend him an umbrella, but Du-sik refuses and goes into the rain. The next day, Sung-hun and Ji-won notes Du-sik being unwell and tells him to take a break and rest. But Du-sik assures them he's fine. Nam-suk gets a call from the bank informing about a high interest rate savings plan. When Nam-suk questioned how the bank could be open on the Sunday, the caller tells her that only a handful of people can get the savings plan. So as she waits till Monday, all the slots will be filled up. As Hye-jin returns from jogging, she spots Nam-suk with an envelope of money. Nam-suk meets with a man in a remote place. As she almost hands the envelope to the man, Hye-jin interferes asking a series of questions. The man grabs the envelope and runs off as Hye-jin chases after him. Sung-hun insists Du-sik to rest. The man runs between them as Hye-jin shouts to Du-sik and Sung-hun to catch him. The two immediately runs after the man. Du-sik makes a shortcut and manages to catch the common. As he pins him to the ground, Du-sik asks him what crime he has done and confess that he chased him because Hye-jin asked him to. The two men then takes the common to the police, and Nam-suk cheerfully thank both Du-sik and Sung-hun for catching the common and getting back her money. When one of the officers blames Nam-suk for being gullible, Hye-jin defends Nam-suk saying she's the victim. After the police takes the common to the police, Hye-jin thanks both Sung-hun and Du-sik. She notes Du-sik being wounded and unwell. But he assures her he's fine, and informs Sung-hun that he needs to go home and rest. As Du-sik lies on his bed coughing and sweating, his doorbell rings. He finds Hye-jin by the door with a first aid box. He tries to shoo her off, but she invites herself in. Disregarding Du-sik's continuous nagging, Hye-jin treats his wound. She then asks him if there's anything he's craving. He says tangerines, because he doesn't have the appetite to eat. Because there are no porridge places, Hye-jin decides to make him some. After she's done making porridge, she finds Du-sik fast asleep. As she's about to leave, she remembers Min-sun asking if Du-sik a good kisser. She unknowingly walks towards him, and even leans for a kiss. But she quickly realizes what she's doing, and hurries out of the house. Du-sik wakes up to find porridge, and a note Hye-jin has left for him asking to finish it to the last drop. As he tastes it, he laughs saying to himself, that porridge couldn't possibly taste any worse. Once he finishes eating, he finds the mess Hye-jin has made in his kitchen, and can barely hold up his anger. Hye-jin runs into Ha-jung, and she invites her over to her restaurant for a cup of coffee. She thanks Hye-jin for helping Num-suk. She explains that even though Num-suk can be a nuisance, everyone in the town let it slide because they want her to be well. Num-suk once had a daughter named Aram who is the same age as Ju-ri, but she was terminally ill. After she dies, Num-suk has lived a miserable life for over a year. She finally found peace when she started making donations in Aram's name to the children's hospital. She also took care of Ju-ri as her own. Hye-jin runs into Num-suk on her way to the clinic. Even though she walked past her, she stops and asks Num-suk to come to the clinic to check if the inlay is done properly. The two makes peace and Num-suk even compliments Hye-jin's beauty. Jun and a member of the boy band arrives to Gari's house. The entire town gather up to see Seon-ho filming the variety show. Du-sik spots Min-sun and invites her in to watch, but sees no trace of Hye-jin. As Hye-jin gets back home after working till late, she nervously walks across the empty streets. Hye-jin accidentally drops the phone and as she bends to pick it up, she sees a shadow. Terrified by it, she starts to run. To her relief, she finds Du-sik with a flashlight, and so Hye-jin runs to him and hugs. Even though Du-sik is startled by it, he wraps his arms around her. And with that, the episode ends. In the epilogue, we flash back to Hye-jin almost kissing Du-sik. After Hye-jin runs out of the house, Du-sik opens his eyes and takes a deep breath. That's it for this video guys, thanks for watching, and hope you enjoyed it. Would very much appreciate if you could like, subscribe, comment and share the video to help out the channel. See you next time.